In this video, I'm going to be showing you a simple way to model this complex spiral stair in Revit. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. As you can see, I have this floor plan. It's an empty project. And let's get started by placing a simple spiral stair in the middle of this project. So go to the stair tool, and then I'm going to select the stair metal plate stringer stair type. I'm going to pick out the full step spiral, and then I'm just going to click here in the middle. For the run width, we can just leave it as is. Click in the middle and then expand it. And let's give it a little bit of space in the middle, just like that. And I'm just going to click here to place the stair and then hit finish. Okay, so once we have the stair, let's go to the 3D view. And now let's make some adjustments to the stair. I just need the basics. So in this case, just the treads. So I'm going to select the railing and hit delete. Then I'm going to select the stair itself and go into edit type. And here in the edit type, let's go to the run type, click on this field, and then click on this little button with three dots. Here, you want to make sure that the treads are on. The tread thickness, let's go with 30 millimeters. Nosing, I'm just going to go down to zero. Risers, we don't need those, and then hit apply. Next, go OK, and then go to supports and set the right support to none and set the left support to none as well and hit apply. And this is what we're left with, just a basic simple set of treads. Now I'm also going to be turning on the shadows just to make this a bit cooler. Okay, moving forward, let's then go back into our floor plan view. And here in the floor plan view, I want to rotate this around where kind of the middle step or the middle tread, when I say middle, I mean kind of middle in the halfway up, is somewhere here on this side. So I'm just going to go here to rotate, place the center of rotation here in the center, and then let's just rotate it like this. Okay, just like that. And okay, so here we have actually two. So let's say I want this one to be in the middle. So what I'll do is I'm just going to go here to annotate, go to detail line, and then just place a simple detail line from here to here, hit the escape key a couple of times, select the stairs, go to rotate, go to place center of rotation, place it here, and then go up to here, the middle point of that detail line, and go down to the reference plane, just like this. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then you can just delete this detail line, and now you know that this tread is basically centered. Okay, so once we have this in place, now what I'll do is I'm just going to go here to architecture and go to reference plane, and I'm just going to mark this up by going here and just leave one mark like that with the reference plane, and another one like so. Okay, just like that. Okay, moving forward, the next step is to model the interesting type of a step. So how do we do this? Well, we need to do this as an in-place component. Now we're going to be hosting that in-place component on this reference plane, which is the center north-south reference plane. So let's go here to component, model in place. We can make this a stair. So search for S for stair, click OK. Stair one, that's fine, click OK. And now let's go to an extrusion. And here let's set a work plane to set work plane and then go with center north south, click OK. Now it's going to tell you, well, you cannot model it in this view. You need another view, and let's open up the south elevation, click open. And this is what we have. Okay, so perfect. So we have the reference planes that we have added. And here we have that step, the middle one that we want to model. So what I'm going to do now is just use pick lines, and I'm going to pick this vertical reference plane. I'm going to pick the top of this tread. Also, I'm going to change the scale to something a bit smaller so the lines aren't so thick, like this, perfect. And yeah, I think this looks all right. So now let's just do a little offset. So let's go with 30 millimeters and offset this line and offset this line down like that. Okay, so I want something like this. And actually, I'm going to move this one down. Let's make the whole thing 200 millimeters like that, or yeah, we can go with 200. Okay, perfect. So we have something that looks like this. Moving forward, let's switch to an arc, and then let's create an arc like that, and I'm just going to move it in. So select it, go to move, and move it from here to there, just like that. Then I'm going to switch to a fillet arc. Let's make the radius 800 for this down part. And first, before we do that, let's use the split element tool. SL is the shortcut. Split this line, hit the escape key a couple of times, then go back to fillet arc, radius 800, and then let's go here with that. Perfect. And then for this one, let's go with something smaller, like 150, and let's do that. Okay, looking really, really good. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Now let's go with the pick lines with an offset of 30 millimeters and then offset this line, this line, this line, this line, this line, and yeah, that should be it. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Again, split element, split this line, hit the escape key a couple of times, go to trim and extend to corner, fix it up here, 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 and here. Okay, now we also need to cap it on top and bottom. So let's go with simple lines and just add a line here as kind of a cap and a line at the bottom as a cap. Perfect. Then go to trim and extend to corner and fix it up here and here. And the same thing goes on top. Just fix it up like that, hit the escape key a couple of times and hit finish. Now go to your floor plan view. Here it's extended 250, that's good. Let's do a minus 250 for start, like so. So it starts here and it ends there, looks perfect. And now we just wanna cut it with this tread. So how do we do that? Well, we need to add a void. So go to create, void forms, void extrusion, and then let's use pick lines and pick this line and this line. And yeah, let's pick, can we pick these? Okay, yeah, we can just use another line here. Okay, so I'm just going to extend this a little bit like that. Extend this like so. And yeah, let's do trim and extend to corner here. Perfect. Also, let's switch this to 25. Yeah, looks much better. Okay, so now we just need to invert this. So I'm just going to do something that looks like this. So this is basically the shape that we're drawing, like that. Okay, looks good. Let's extend it a bit here. Okay, looking perfect. Now go to the 3D view. We have this void, we have this shape. So now when I hit finish and extend this void all the way up, basically we have one tread complete. Now we can just hit finish model and this is what we have. Okay, now moving forward, let's go down to our leveled one floor plan. So now it's just a matter of copying this and modifying it. So I'm just going to show you on a couple of examples. So basically what you want to do is select this thing, go to rotate, click copy, place it here, go from here to here. There we go. Now we have a new one. Now for this one, what we want to do is we just want to rotate that down. And for rotation, we do need to add an additional line. So let's add a detail line like so. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Now you want to make a big cross selection like this. Go to filter, check none, and then just check the stairs and the stair runs. Hit apply, okay. Go to rotate, really important, uncheck copy. Go to place and then place it here. Now you find the middle of that detail line and move it down to your reference plane. Okay, perfect. Now we can delete this line here because we don't need it at the moment. We can select this one, go into edit in place. Okay, and then we wanna edit this thing, edit extrusion, pick out the south elevation. And now the next step is just to select this thing and then move it down. So we're just going to move it from here down to, yeah, there. Perfect. Go back to the 3D view, go to extrusion, hit finish again, and now as you can see, we have it on the next step. So basically, now I'm just going to continue doing this over and over and over again until I complete the entire stair. And we continue going until we get to this point where now what you'll see is when I move this down, just like so, let's see. Okay, there we go. Now this is going kind of past the bottom. So what we want to do here is just select the vertical ones and hit delete, and then go to trim and extend to corner and basically trim and extend this part. So basically we're just kind of cutting this short over here, hit finish, and yeah, there we go. And we're just going to be doing the same thing when we go to the other side and go to the top. So now I'm just going to be speeding this up again. So enjoy the rest of this kind of speed run of creating this stair. And here we go, now we're done. So I'm just going to select the stairs that we have here and I can just delete those. And in the end, we're left with this pretty artistic piece of stair of model in place architecture. I think this looks really, really beautiful. Also, it looks something that's impossible to do in Revit. However, as you have just seen, it's not impossible at all. It's actually very straightforward. It is a little bit repetitive. And if you have a way to automate this, I would love to hear it. So please tell me in the comment section just below this video. Also, if you would like to get this Revit project file so you don't have to do it on your own, I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. That's my Patreon page where I upload all of my Revit project files from these Revit tutorials. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.